know, your ass better call somebody.
Voilà. T'as une chopstick.
So we have all these different alcohols that we're going to try, that I'm really excited to try. So I've tried some of these beers before, but I've never tried these alcohols. But they can be pretty strong. So to help me with that, I have this chicken going. So chicken and beer is a really great combination. In Korea, they have a word for it, which is chimae, which is kind of a portmanteau of the words chicken and meju meaning beer. One of these was about $1 to $2 in that. So it makes me a little nervous to try this out. We have San Miguel apple flavor. We have San Miguel light, San Miguel pilsen, and then we have red one. So I think this is going from maybe weakest to strongest. Then we have this Ginebra San Miguel, is a gin. And then we have this Savanna, it is a rum, and it's a tandoori rum. So why don't we start off something simple? Why don't we start off with this beer, so San Miguel flavor beer. There's also a lemon flavor. I'm excited about the apple flavors. I really enjoy apple flavors. All right, so by the way, it smells really nice. It smells like hard apple cider. Let's check it out. Ooh, it's really lovely. So this is only 3% alcohol, so it's not very strong. It tastes like a hard apple cider that we're used to. But a little watered down. It doesn't have a strong flavor. And so next up we're going to try the San Miguel Lime. So this is a pretty popular beer that I see all around the Philippines. Usually this one is a little bit cheaper than the Pilsen, so I think a lot of people enjoy this before I understand, especially women like to drink it. It says it's 5% alcohol, so it's a little stronger than previous beer. And it says it has only 100 calories. So I'm assuming it's going to be a pretty light beer. Let's go ahead and check that out. Oh, it's really light. I would say this is almost like water plus beer. Kind of similar to Cookin S. Maybe a little more water down on that. It's not bad. I think this is something you have to drink a lot of if your intention is to get really drunk. Alright, so next let's move on to San Miguel Pale. So I've actually drank this quite often. This is a beer that I really enjoy drinking. So this is also 5% alcohol, so it's the same as the light. I'm assuming it has more calories than it says. This has been since 1990. So a pretty old beer. It describes itself as a truly satisfying beer with quite a well-balanced flavor. So I have pretty promising expectations for this. This is more of a light style. So the light beer, this to me is just light. I don't really enjoy it. It's really light beer. It's got plenty of flavor. It's just really refreshing still. It's not really empowering. I can tell that if I drink a few of these. I'm probably going to get pretty tipsy pretty quickly. But it's not going to be that bad. I can still enjoy it quite a while. So this is kind of, for me, the base standard for Pilsen beers, because to me this is just kind of good. Right, so anything lower than this to me is just meh. Anything higher, such as this Red Horse, I'm not sure about. I've never tried that, so why don't we move on to that one next? Right, so next we have the Red Horse. Right, so the can looks really nice. It says Red Horse, extra strong, good, extra strong beer. This is 6.9% alcohol, so quite a bit stronger than Pilsen. So from what I have heard, people that want to get drunk quickly and efficiently will go to this. Let's go ahead and see. Does it smell? It probably smells as kind of an old beer. Okay. It does taste stronger. It does a lot more alcohol than that than the pale Pilsen. I would say after you swallow it, like an aftertaste, it's almost like a slight burning sensation. It's like a shadow whiskey, it's like a burning feeling, right? It's almost kind of like that. Maybe that's what the extra strong power comes in. Alright, so now moving on, we have three different Filipino style alcohols. So I'm a little bit nervous to try this again just because the amount that I can get for the price just kind of scares me on how they're going to taste. So I think the one that scares me the most is this one. So I'm going to go for this one first. So this is Ginebra S. Miguel. So it is 80 proof, so it's and it says it is for domestic sale only. The amount is for 50 pesos. Yes, 50 pesos is about $1. So what I'm going to do is, first I'm going to just try to take a shot of it, or maybe half a shot, and then I'm going to try mixing it. So from what I understand, these aren't really meant to be drunk on their own, they are meant to be mixed. So I have some Jamaica lime juice, and I also have some pineapple juice. So we can try a few flavors, because I always like to broaden my pineapple together. And if the flavor is too strong, then I add my chicken joint from Jollibee. So if you don't know, Jollibee is the number one fast food company here in the Philippines. It has branches all around the world. It is well known for its chicken joint and their fried chicken. So I have two pieces of their spicy fried chicken, as well as some rice and some of their gravy. So, as I said, you bring this very normal fried chicken here from together, like peanut butter and jelly. So this is just a good opportunity to try this really grass. Yeah. So on the angle, it is, it looks like, I'm not sure if that is made that sense again. I don't know, you can tell me right in the comment section below. It looks like he's fighting Lucifer. So anytime I drink something that has a picture of Satan, I'm going to be nervous. Alright, so let's go ahead and open this up. Something that I've learned is to never smell alcohol. Anybody that smells alcohol like this is just asking punishment. I'm going to try just a small drop because it's about 100 here. And then after this, we'll try mixing and place in this lime juice to see if it tastes any different. So, here we go. Cheers.
Please like and subscribe and hit the notification bell.